Yo, what's good? It's Young Honey, and we're going to be making something extremely funky today. So I want to get right into it real quick. I haven't done it before, but I do want to shout out Arturia and Output just because I got a lot of my samples from there, and they are truly an awesome tool. I'm not even being paid to say that. I don't get benefits to say that. I think it's pretty fucking tight. They do it all. You pay like $10-$20 a month, and it's just there. It's all there for you. All of it. Everything you need. Everything. The whole package, if you will. All of it. Alright, let's run it. I'm just gonna put down some like white noise, cause I want this bitch to be ambient as hell. That should work. I'm gonna add that kind of in the mix everywhere. That up. I did indeed. Thankfully we do have tools like quantizing buttons and drawing in tools, but still, that was not a great oversight on my part. Now I'm just literally gonna keep adding shit like, as I go. See what I can do. I'm a fool. That's what I was looking for.
Thank you.
these lines to the nearest quarter. Yard. Gotta extend something over. Perfect. Get some bass in there. Again, just like always, I really don't like messing around too much with bass and getting it too complex, just because A, it's not really something I'm great at, but also because I like keeping it simple for the artist. Drums coming up on about 10 minutes and getting close. Thank you. On the EQ for this, usually I have everything a lot louder initially, but I'm pretty excited because I got a lot of room with the EQ. Be satisfied. So that's gonna be like the whole verse part of it. Let me go get the hook made. I'm gonna do the same as white noise. Keep it basic. And then I don't really want to do a bass for this, so I'm gonna, like this part of it at least, I'm gonna turn to the dumbest instrument there is, the mellotron. The mellotron always holds it down, because it's an instrument that samples other instruments. Fucking genius. Does sound like shit though. That's why I love it. That may not be a substitute for a bass, but on the sneaky little trick, I'm just gonna copy it into the bass. And I'm gonna move all the notes down a couple octaves. And then, congratulations, you have yourself a bass line from a top melody. That's on science, my builders. It's like that.
I'm at the cathedral. A lot of soldiers here.
System overload, son of a dick. I joke, respect your systems. Don't let them overload. Now I'm just gonna put in a little intro. A little intro to set the tone. Copy and paste that. Bunch of white noise for the outro. Then let's start modifying the drums a little bit. I'm just gonna put in a couple breaks here and there. Get it so that instead of that that last part of the drums just comes. So I'm gonna do that for a few other parts of this.
Sure.
It just makes life a lot easier. It also makes your drums a lot catchier, it adds a little bit of bounce, and it gives the artist a little bit of wiggle room to kind of finish up their bar how they want to. I personally like having that little gap. And yeah, let's play this fella through. Just once. Come on.
I'm at the Special Forces base.
Get to a computer. See if they have any intel Libertad could use. And watch your ass.
Always do. Got a nice one, actually.
That's all I got. Have a great one, everyone. Like and subscribe if you enjoy this kind of content.